we speak about metal, most of the time we forget to speak about the real, true heavy metal. Yes, there are many genres inside the metal community. We have doom metal, thrash metal, black metal, death metal, progressive metal, gothic metal, glam metal, and so on and so on and so on. But in any case, we don't have to forget the real heavy metal. So inside our history of heavy metal, we have two genres that came to bring back to the people, to the metalheads, the love of the authentic true heavy metal. The first genre was in the years of the 90s, in the last years of the 90s, something between 1997 and 1999. And this genre was called by the name true heavy metal. Of course, inside all the 90s, we had many power metal bands from Europe, and many Euro power metal bands. But in any case, this new genre, it was even more close to the traditional heavy metal. First of all, I will speak about these two genres, and I'm starting with the first genre of the 90s. It started with this album, Glory to the Brave, of Hammerfall from Sweden. And yes, until now, maybe this is the best album of Hammerfall. But this album is not only important about Hammerfall, is also important about the whole genre and also about the whole story of heavy metal, of traditional heavy metal. Also here they played a cover, Child of the Damned, of Warlord from United States. So Hammerfall opened this genre, and afterwards came many bands. Let's speak about some of them. Sacred Steel from Germany, and their first album, Reborn in Steel. They were even a little bit more epic metal. Another band from Australia, they played power metal, heavy power metal, Pegasus. This is their second album of them, Wings of Destiny. Another band from Germany that became even more famous with their third album. They played in the beginning something like Europower. They continued the way of Stratovarius. Ed Guy and their third album, Vainglory Opera. Another band from Sweden with their first album, debut album, Crystal Eyes. And the debut album, World of Black and Silver. Another band from Germany, Paragon. And this is maybe the first album of them, The Final Command. Also here they played a cover of the band Warrior from United States, Fighting for the Earth. Also, I'm continuing with Germany and the band Primal Fear. Here we have heavy metal in the way of Judas Priest. The singer was the first singer of Gamma Ray, and also the guitarist was Matt Sinner of the band Sinner, the German band Sinner. And they continue until today the way of Judas Priest heavy metal. Also another band from Germany in these years, Metallium. Here I bring their fourth album as One Chapter 4, but they became very, very famous with their first album. And also in these years we had many albums and bands that came from Italy. So first of all, Rhapsody with their first album, Legendary Tales. They played the way something about symphonic epic power metal or symphonic Hollywood power metal. Today we have also Rhapsody of Fire, we have Rhapsody of Look at Riley and of Lione. Also we had another band, Labyrinth, from Italy, and I will speak also about some other bands from Italy of these years. White Skull and their album Tales from the North. They had a woman as singer in these years, and here also in one song came to sing the singer of Grave Digger. Drakkar, also from Italy, their debut album Quest for Glory. Here we have some influences of Running Wild. And a great epic metal band from Italy. In their first album they played even more epic, afterwards they played even more power metal, Domine. And their first album, Champion Eternal. This was the band that came out from this scene of the true heavy metal of the 90s, of the last years of the 90s. Afterwards came the millennium, the new millennium, came the new styles, came the new metal, afterwards metalcore, and most of these bands, maybe some of them they continue until today, but most of these bands became less and less famous. But in any case, in the new millennium, in 2008, we had another wave, a second wave of traditional heavy metal, but today we know it as the new wave of traditional heavy metal, that is started with this album, the first album of Enforcer from Sweden, Into the Night. And yes, this album even is a little bit more speed metal. And they have also influences from speed and thrash metal, Enforcer. But Enforcer opened the gate for so many other bands. For example. But before that I will speak about the other bands, it was also another band, even before Enforcer, from Sweden, Bullet. And they played a style something between AC/DC and Accept influences. Here I bring the album of them hitting for the top. And now, let's start. An American band, White Wizard, and their first album, Over the Top. Also, they became many very, very famous because of the first EP of them. Another band from Sweden. And they played something like heavy metal with Thin Lizzy influences. Also, members of Enforcer were inside them. Black Trip and their first album, Going Under. Now, a band from Canada, their second album of them, Striker, and their second album of them, Armed to the Teeth. Here we can see the influences of new wave of British heavy metal. Another also band from Canada, Skullfist, and their first album, Head of the Pack. Another band from Sweden, Ram. They played the style of Judas Priest heavy metal, also their first album, First Entry. A band from Germany, Alpha Tiger, and their album, Man or Machine. Also here I could also bring Holy Grail from United States. Some members of them that were inside White Wizard before. Ride the Void, their album. And also we can bring some bands that they played the way of Merciful Fate heavy metal. First of all, In Solitude from Sweden. They made only three albums, and in their second album they played the real way of Merciful Fate heavy metal. the world, the flesh, the devil. Another band from Sweden, also with members of Enforcer, Tribulation. Their beginning was even more death metal, but here we have many gothic also and heavy metal influences. The Children of the Night. And another also band from Sweden that they play the Way of Merciful Fate, Portrait, and their album Crossroads. So I'm continuing now with bands that they play the Way of Iron Maiden. First of all, the Americans, Night Demon, and their second album Darkness Remains. Also the mastermind of the band, he is the real man that he pulls Sith uncle Kirith uncle to come back with a new album also. Another band, Blade Killer, and their first album High Risk, in the Way of Iron Maiden. And another Iron Maiden influenced band from England, Monument. Until now they have three albums. This is the first album, Renegades. The singer also is from Greece. And some other bands that they played away even more of epic metal from influences of Manowar, and not only. First of all, the German band from Bavaria, Atlantean Context. Their first album, The Golden Bow. Visigoth from United States, from Utah of United States. Their first album, The Reverend King. Also their second album is great. Eternal Champion, also from United States, from Texas. Their first album, The Armor of Iron. Now, from Canada, Gatekeeper. They play something between epic metal and something between speed metal of the Wall of Jericho, of Halloween days. And their first album, East of Sun. Another band from Canada, new band, Smulder. Times of Obscene Evil and Wild Daring, their first album. And I'm continuing with Canada, with two great albums of new wave of traditional heavy metal, Riot City, and their debut album, Burn the Night. And of course, Traveler, with their first debut album from Canada. So we can see that this second wave of new wave of traditional heavy metal continues until today, and because of these bands, also of this of the genre of true heavy metal, and also of the genre of the new wave of traditional heavy metal, we have so many new people, new metalheads, young metalheads, that they are coming to know the real, authentic, true heavy metal. So from Jerusalem and from Israel, stay metal and stay heavy.